हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू ऑल फोर सी लर्निंग क्लासेस। नाउ टुडेज टॉपिक इज एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ इंटेंसिटी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड। ओके, सो इन द लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड सम एप्लीकेशंस रिगार्डिंग इंटेंसिटी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड। नाउ द अदर वन इज, सी फॉर एग्जांपल, हियर वी आर टेकिंग ए स्क्वेयर ऑफ एनी साइड। ओके, दिस इज अ स्क्वेयर ऑफ एनी साइड। If three like charges are kept at the three corners of a square, and the fourth corner, if you are placing a negative charge, minus q negative charge is placed. At three corners, positive charges are placed, and the fourth corner, here we are placing same magnitude but opposite sign of negative charge, minus q is placed. Now we should find the intensity, resultant intensity of electric field at the center of the square. Okay, see, this is one of the diagonal, this is another diagonal. Now this is a OB, the center of the square. Okay, now calculate the intensity of electric field by the individually by these four charges. So let us take, this is a first charge, again this is a second charge, this is a third one, and here it is a fourth charge. Now let us take E1 be the intensity of electric field by the first charge. What is the magnitude of E1 here? Magnitude of E1 is equals to magnitude of E2 is equals to magnitude of E3 is equals to magnitude of E4. All are same magnitudes, and the direction and the charge location of the charge from center is also same. So which is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by, if r is the distance from center to the corner, we may write 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. Okay, so now what is the direction of E1? See, this is a positive charge, the direction of electric field is radially outwards, this is the direction of E1 here. Now again second charge is also positive. What is the direction again? Radially outwards from the charge, this is the direction of E2. Third charge is also positive, same magnitude, same distance. The direction is radially outwards, this is the direction of E3. And what about the direction of E4? See, fourth charge is a negative. Okay, then what is the direction of intensity of electric field? Is radially inwards, that is towards the charge, this is the direction of E4 here. Now four intensities of electric field at the center due to these four charges is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. Okay, so if you are observing these diagram, E1 and E3 are equal magnitude, opposite directions, so they cancelled with each other. Okay, but what about E2 and E4 having the same magnitude, same direction? So here the net intensity of electric field, E net is equals to vector sum of E1 bar plus E2 bar plus E3 bar plus E4 bar. Okay, but in that, what is E1, E3 are equal magnitude, opposite direction, they cancelled with each other, therefore the net magnetic field in the net electric field intensity is due to the these two charges, that is sum of the E2 and E4, because they are in the same direction, which is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 q by r square. This is a resultant intensity of electric field in this case when three positive charges and the fourth one is negative charges are kept at the four corners of a square of any side, and from center to any corner, what is the distance here we are assuming r, then the resultant intensity of electric field at the center is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 q by r square. Coming to the second one, if three identical charges are kept at the vertices of an equilateral triangle, of any side, let us take, now let it be an equilateral triangle. Okay, A, B, C be the equilateral triangle. Now three charges, identical charges. Let us take all our positive charges plus Q. This is also plus Q here, and it is also plus Q. Kept at the vertices of an equilateral triangle of any side. Okay. Now we should find the resultant intensity of electric field at the centroid of the triangle. Centroid. Okay. Now, what is the three vertices, three corners are equidistant from the centroid. The three corners are equidistant from the centroid. And all are positive charges. Let us take the distance, okay, actually depends upon the side. But here we are writing the distance is equal, let it be R. Okay. Now, what is this? Let us take this is a first charge. This is a second charge and here it is third charge. Okay. Now what is the intensity of electric field at the center, at the centroid of the equilateral triangle by the first charge? Let it be E1. What is E1 bar is equals to, we may write 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. What is the charge here? Q by R square. Okay. Similarly, the magnitude of E2 is equals to E3 is equals to, this is the magnitude of E1. Again, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. But again, what are intensity of electric field is a vector? We should specify the directions. So, what is the direction of E1? This is a positive charge. So, this is a direction of E1 here. And second charge is also positive. The direction of electric field radially outwards. This is a direction of E2 here. And third one is also positive charge. Electric field intensity radially outwards. This is a direction of E3. And the angle between E1, E2 or E2, E3 and E1, E3 are same. That is equals to 120 degrees. Now magnitudes are same and 3 E1 is equal to E2 is equal to E3 and they are at an angle of 120 degrees with each other. So what is the resultant intensity of electric field here also? E net is equals to vector sum of E1 plus E2 plus E3. The vector sum of individual intensities of electric field. See, whenever we are calculating the resultant of E2 and E3, these two are equal magnitude and they are at an angle of 120 degrees with each other. When two vectors having equal magnitudes and the angle between them 120 degrees, the resultant is equals to either of the vector. So, the resultant of E2 and E3 is equals to either E2 or E3. And what is its direction? It is along the bisector of the angle between these two. Means, if the angle between E2 and E3 is 120 degrees, it is exactly along this line, opposite to the E1. The direction of resultant of E2 and E3 is opposite to E1. And what is, finally, the net intensity of electric field becomes a zero. Here also, the resultant intensity of electric field is a zero. Okay. You may take any closed side and identical charges are kept at the vertices of either closed side of the vertices of either triangle or square or hexagon. The resultant intensity of electric field at the center becomes a zero. Now coming to the next one, you may take third one. Now let us take six identical charges are kept at the vertices of a regular hexagon of side A. Okay. Now consider this is a one of the regular hexagon. Let us take this is a charge Q here. Again another charge Q. Third charge is Q. Fourth charge is also Q, Q, Q. 6 identical charges are kept at the vertices of a regular hexagon of side A. Let us take the side is A here. Now again here also we need to find the resultant intensity of electric field at the center. Net intensity of electric field at the center of the hexagon. Let us take this point O be the center of the hexagon. O be the point center of the hexagon. Let us take this is the first charge, this is the second one, and this is third charge, fourth one, fifth one, and sixth one. Six identical charges are kept at the vertices of regular hexagon of side A. Now we need to find the net intensity of electric field due to system of these six charges at the center of the hexagon. Now again all are positive charges and all are equidistant from the center. All are equidistant from the center. So what is the distance of the corner to the center is equals to side here. If it is A, this is also A here. The side is A here. Okay. Now what is the magnitude of intensity of electric field at the center O by these six charges remains the same. That is magnitude of E1 is equals to magnitude of E2 is equals to magnitude of E3 is equals to magnitude of E4 is equals to magnitude of E5 is equals to magnitude of E6. Okay, and what about its value is, which is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. What are the charge here? Q be the charge, and what is the distance from center to the corner? A. So Q by A square. Now what is the directions? See, all are positive charges only. The direction of electric field by these six charges is radially outwards. See, let us take this is the first charge. This is the direction of E1 radially outwards. And this is the second charge which is also positive. The direction of electric field again radially outwards. And third charge is also positive. Direction of electric field is radially outwards. And fourth one positive radially outwards. Fifth one is also positive charge direction radially outwards. Sixth one positive radially outwards. So if you are observing these diagrams, all are equal magnitude and pair of electric field intensity. See here E1, E4 equal magnitude, opposite in directions. So these two are cancelled with each other, E1 and E4. And E2, E5 equal magnitude, opposite directions. They cancelled with each other. E3 and E6 equal magnitude, opposite directions. They cancelled with each other. Therefore, the net intensity of electric field at the center of the regular hexagon is zero. So, three sets, all are equal magnitude, opposite direction, they cancel. Okay? For suppose, in this case, if you take any one of the corner empty, sixth charge is removed. Okay? Now, here, only five charges are kept at the five corners. Okay? Sixth corner is kept empty. Then what happens? Here E1, E2, E3, E4, E5. There is no intensity of electric field. By the sixth, there is no charge here. So what happens in such conditions? See, same magnitude. Okay. We know the directions. But what is here? There is no sixth one. There is no sixth charge here. Intensity of electric field by the first charge. Radially outwards. Second charge, radially outwards, positive only. Third charge, positive, radially outwards. Fourth charge is positive, radially outwards. Fifth charge is also positive, radially outwards. But there is no sixth charge here. Same. What is this? E1 is equals to E2 is equal to E3, which is equal to E4 is equal to E5. Formula, that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by A square. Right? Now, E1, E4 are equal magnitude, opposite directions. They cancelled. Two vectors having equal magnitude, opposite direction. The resultant of these two is zero. Here also E2, E5. Equal and opposite cancel. Zero. But E3 is along the, towards the left side. here there is no opposing intensity of electric field. So E3 should not be cancelled here. Cannot be cancelled. Okay. What is the net intensity of electric field? Again, we may write actually the vector sum of the individual intensities of electric field. E1 bar plus E2 bar plus E3 bar plus E4 bar plus E5 bar. In this, E1, E4 cancelled, equal and opposite. E2, E5 equal and opposite cancelled. Okay? But E3 cannot be cancelled. So the resultant intensity of electric field is nothing but only that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by a square. Okay? So this is a net intensity of electric field. When, when 5 charges are kept at the 5 corners of a regular hexagon and 6th corner is empty, then the net intensity of electric field at the center of the regular hexagon of side A is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by a square. Okay? For example, again here we are taking 6th corner, but 6th corner is negative, same magnitude, and 6th corner here we are taking the negative charge. In such condition, what happens? The resultant intensity of electric field. See here. Same E1, E2, E3, E4, E5. Again, E6 is also there. This is a direction of magnitude of E6. What is the value? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by a square. E1 positive charge outwards. E2, this is our second charge positive outwards. Third charge positive radially outwards. Fourth charge is also positive radially outwards. Fifth charge is positive radially outwards. But what about the sixth corner? At the sixth corner, here we are taking negative charge. Sixth corner, negative charge is there. We know that what is the direction of intensity of electric field due to these negative charges? Radially inwards. So radially inwards means you should keep this is a direction of E6 here. Okay, this is a direction of E6. Now, if you are observing again this diagram, what is the resultant intensity of electric field? We may write like this. Vector sum of the individual intensities of electric field. E1 plus E2 plus E3 plus E4 plus E5 plus E6. But E1, E4 equal magnitude opposite in directions. E2, E5 equal in magnitude opposite in directions. But E3 and E6 are in the same directions. E3 and E6 are in the same directions. Therefore, we may write what is E net is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by a square plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by a square, which is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2q by a square. This is a net intensity of electric field at the center of the regular hexagon when 5 charges are positive, identical charges are kept at the corners of the regular hexagon, but 6th corner if you are taking negative sign, then the resultant intensity of electric field at the center is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2q by a square. Okay. One problem. For example, here if infinite number of electric charges having equal magnitude, each of magnitude is equals to 5 nanocoulombs, are arranged on the x-axis. Infinite number of charges, each equals to 5 nanocoulomb. What is Q1 is 5 nanocoulomb. Second one is also 5 nanocoulombs. Third one, 5 nanocoulombs. Fourth one, again 5 nanocoulombs. Are arranged on the x-axis at a distance of x is equal to 1 centimeter, x is equals to 2 centimeters, x is equal to 4 centimeters, x is equals to 8 centimeters, and so on. And in this setup, consecutive charges having opposite sign. Consecutive charges having opposite sign. So, first one is पॉजिटिव चार्ज, सेकंड वन इज नेगेटिव, थर्ड वन इज पॉजिटिव, फोर्थ वन इज नेगेटिव. वट इज फोर्थ चार्ज इज नेगेटिव. अगेन fifth one is positive, sixth one is negative. Like that, infinite number of charges are arranged on the x-axis. Then we should find the resultant intensity of electric field at x is equals to zero at the origin by using again what is the principle of superposition. So we know that what is the net intensity of electric field by the principle of superposition. E net is equals to E1 bar plus E2 bar plus E3 bar plus E4 bar and so on, infinite number of terms. Okay, in all the terms, if you are observing these, all are equal magnitude but different distances, consecutive charges having opposite signs. So the net intensity of electric field we may write like this. Q is common, Q by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by R1 square plus 1 by R2 square. Second charge is negative, so here you will get negative. Plus 1 by R3 square minus 1 by R4 square plus 1 by R5 square and so on up to infinite number of terms. What is the value of Q? 5 nano coulombs, 5 into 10 power minus 9. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught value 9 into 10 power 9. 1 by R1 square, R1 1 centimeter, 1 by 1 square minus 1 by 2 square plus 1 by 4 square minus 1 by 8 square plus and so on infinity. But these are in centimeters, you should convert into meter, you will get 1 by 10 power minus 2 whole square means minus 4. Okay, so 45 plus 9 minus 9 cancel. 1 minus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 16 minus 1 by 64 plus and so on infinite number of terms. So they are in geometrical progressions, they are in GP. What is the sum of the infinite terms? We have an expression, S infinity is equals to A by 1 minus R. Here what is A is equals to 1, R is equals to minus 1 by 4. Substitute the values here. 45 into A by, A is the first letter 1, 1 minus of minus 1 by 4. Okay, then what is the value? That is equals to 45 into 1 by 1 plus 1 by 4. 1 plus 1 by 4. That is equals to, and here into 10 power minus 4. Here also 1 by 10 power minus 4. It becomes into 10 power 4. 45 into 1 by 1 plus 5 by 4, 4 plus 1, 5 by 4 becomes 4 by 5 into 10 power 4. That is 5 1s are 5 9s are 9 4s are 36. 36 into 10 to the power of 4 Newton per coulomb. Okay, this is about the solution. What is 36 into 10 power 4 Newton per coulomb when infinite number of charges are arranged on the x-axis at a distance 1, 2, 4, 8 centimeters and so on, and consecutive charges having opposite sign, the resultant intensity of electric field at x is equal to 0 is 36 into 10 power 4 Newton per coulomb. Okay.